Hello, one and all, and welcome to me talking about my favorite music from 2018. And yes, I know it's September and that 2018 ended over 8 months ago, but I don't care. I mean, honestly, it's my goal just to start releasing these later and later into the year. But anyways, welcome to what I consider to be my favorite music of the past year. As per usual, this is just my opinion, you know, as should be obvious. Alright, without further ado, let's start with my favorite artist of the past year and like... come on, we already know who it is. That's right, it's the Chainsmokers once again! And while many of you may think that I'm joking, I'm really not. I mean, according to Spotify, the Chainsmokers was my second most listened to artist of 2018. It isn't because my Spotify account was linked to my family's Alexa for a period of time, and my mom constantly asked for Alexa to play the Chainsmokers. No. Hell no, I'm just that big of a fan. So congratulations, Chainsmokers, best artist of the year, 2 years in a row. Alright, moving on to my favorite remixes of the year. First up, at number 3, is Squirrelcore's remix of the Final Station soundtrack. While this would technically fit a bit better in the EP section since it's a collection of remixes, I'm putting it here because they're all remixes of the same soundtrack, and it's my list, so I make up the rules. Anyways, while I haven't played the Final Station, it's easy to appreciate the effort and personal style Squirrelcore gave to the soundtrack. Every song hits hard with its percussion, and yeah, like, I know it's breakcore, but with the remixes here, each song transitions between extremely hard hitting to some more ambient and gritty tracks. I was pleasantly surprised with this one. My favorite track off of it was The Arrival. Up next at number 2 is Ryan Hemsworth's remix of Will He by Joji. I love the original by Joji, and this remix gives it a whole new vibe. It honestly feels like some soundtrack to a spy movie with its melancholy guitar chords, and while that sounds far-fetched, well, it kinda is, but trust me when I say it really, really works. Finally, my favorite remix of the year was Skrillex's remix of The Island Part 1 by Pendulum. This was another remix where I already enjoyed the original track, but Skrillex came in and decided to put his own spin on it, which surprisingly turned out to be some great future bass. I won't lie, it might be my nostalgia for the original song that's clouding my impression of this track, but with the variety of audio chops and synths fighting for attention at the drop, I really don't think my rose-tinted goggles are the only thing making me enjoy this remix as much as I do. Alright, enough of that. Next up are my favorite singles of the year, and first up at number 6 is Tale of Abandoned by Miss.Inc. This lo-fi beat is somber, and while it is a bit simple at face value, I can't help but lose myself to it every time I put it on. Next up at number 5 is Had It All by Smith Musics featuring Chuck New. This is just a plain fun and funky beat with a pretty chill tone to it. Absolutely enjoyed it. At number 4 is Insane in the Rain's jazz arrangement of Rain from the Halo 3 ODST soundtrack. Halo 3 ODST might be one of, if not, my favorite Halo games, and this game has one of the best soundtracks in the series. Insane in the Rain puts his own jazz twist to it while emphasizing the loneliness and mystery of the original song. Number 3 is If the Car Beside You Moves Ahead by James Blake. Like the name suggests, this song is perfect for just driving down the road at night with its pitched, chopped vocals and deep chords in the background. It weirdly makes you feel both relaxed and stressed all at the same time. At number 2 is Hot Pink by Let's Eat Grandma. Alright. I'll be honest, the only reason I even listened to the song to begin with was because I found out it was produced by Sophie. But I mean, how could I not with Sophie's amazing track record? This song makes perfect use of Let's Eat Grandma's vocals and Sophie's weird, brash production to the point where the drops in this song just sound plain evil. Alright, and now for my favorite single of the year, and it is Feels Like Summer by Childish Gambino. This Is America had a great, deep music video and all, but Feels Like Summer stuck with me more for just being a way more catchy and relaxing song that couldn't stop replaying. As the name of the song suggests, the production and vocals really are reminiscent of summer, with the entire thing making you feel like you're listening to it at the end of a long, hot summer day. Next up are my favorite video game soundtracks of the past year, and unfortunately there's only two games on the list this year. I didn't really play that many games last year, and I definitely didn't get around to playing any of the games whose soundtracks got endless amounts of praise, so only two for me to mention this year. The first of which is the Florence soundtrack by Kevin Penkin. This soundtrack is absolutely gorgeous, and every single emotion displayed in this game is amplified thanks to it. Every sweeping violin chord or piano melody is used perfectly to get you to truly connect to Florence and empathize with her through this heartwarming story. My favorite track from it was Happy Together. And for my favorite soundtrack of the year, it's another Annapurna published game. That's right, it's Donut County's soundtrack by Daniel Koestner and Ben Esposito. This soundtrack is incredibly mellow and relaxing and fits the overall laid-back tone of the game. With its relaxed guitar chords alongside some vocal cuts and lines randomly thrown into the mix, it makes for a great soundtrack to just play in the background as you go about your day. My favorite track from it is Bird of Paradise. Next category is my favorite EPs of the year, and starting it off at number 6 is Bike Beats by Saiken. Some tranquil and soothing lo-fi hip-hop with this one. I love the vocal chops and samples just littered and repeated with each loop on the track. Disclaimer, I suppose that I do know Saiken, and that's how I found his music, but regardless of all that, this EP still slaps. My favorite track is Cold Love. Next, at number 5 is Aphex Twin's Collapse EP. Aphex Twin brings their signature trippy and crisp IDM with every single drum, bass, and clap on the song beating over your eardrums from all over, all the while maintaining that chilling atmosphere they're known for. My favorite track from it is First 44. At number 4 is Vicious Circles by Sinjin Hawk and Zora Jones. Damn, this EP is just crazy. You have this huge variety of melodies, synths, and percussion assaulting you on each track at its highest points. This EP perfectly showcases both artists' styles and talents, with my favorite track being Lurk 101. My third favorite EP of the year was My Dear Melancholy by The Weeknd. Honestly, after the letdown that was Starboy, this EP was a breath of fresh air. Maybe I'm just a sucker for depressing heartbreak songs, but every song in this EP hit me hard to the point where I could feel the Weeknd's pain with every word. The production, as usual with The Weeknd, was stellar, with Gesaffelstein even jumping in to spice up a few tracks. My favorite track from it was I Was Never There featuring Gesaffelstein. My runner-up for best EP of the year was Home Movies by Technicolor Bear. Some dreamlike trip-hop on this EP with a great mix of groovy and relaxed songs, with some tasteful samples thrown in as well. My favorite track from it is Adrift. Goodbye. And now for my favorite EP of the year, it's Crush by Raven Lanae. This EP is a masterpiece, with Lanae showcasing some marvelous performances alongside some funky production. Lanae also showcases some great songwriting on here with a mature approach to some tough topics such as long-distance relationships. Every melody wormed its way into my head, with Lanae's vocals at the forefront of every single one. My favorite track off of it is the leading single, Sticky. And now we're at our final section of this video, my favorite albums of the year. And holy shit, it was very difficult to narrow this down to 6 albums. There were just so many great albums that could have easily ended up here, and you'll see what I mean when I name my honorable mentions later. Anyways, kicking us off at number 6 is Apophenia by Mr. Bill. This album has a fantastic mix of Mr. Bill's signature IDM and glitch. Every song has this wide mix of different synths and metallic sound effects thrown into the background, while some soothing and complex melodies take center stage. Mr. Bill continues to impress with this album, with my favorite tracks being Composite 12, Sisyphus, and Korat 7B. At number 5 is Dirty Computer by Janelle Monáe. This album is loud. It's sexy. It shows Monáe at her most vulnerable and powerful at the same time. Every leading line in chorus is catchy, with Monáe's talents easily shining through some stylishly written lines. There are a good number of features on here, but they do nothing to distract from Monáe herself and help give each song their own personality and message, like with Pharrell Williams on I Got the Juice or Grimes on Pink. My favorites off this album are I Got the Juice, Take a Bite, and the leading single, Make Me Feel. That's just the way you make me feel. Next up at 4 is Oil of Every Pearl's Uninsides by Sophie. Yes, more Sophie music. Sue me. Listening to this album is honestly confusing and disorienting, and while it doesn't sound like a good thing, it is. You have these bouncy, energetic electronic pop songs with It's Okay to Cry and Immaterial, and then you got these hard, intense bangers with Pony Boy and Face Shopping before going into a gloriously haunting ambient track, Pretending. It all culminates with this 9-minute extreme electronic ballad, Whole New World / Pretend World. This album is a journey with many twists and turns that you won't regret taking. My favorite tracks from it are Face Shopping, Immaterial, and Whole New World, Pretend World. Number 3 of the year is the self-titled album from Kid See Ghosts. Hot damn, Kid Cudi and Kanye West brought some absolute fire with this one. Every single track on it is the best track on the album. High production value on each one, with each artist constantly tackling different topics with their lyrics. Kanye with his tumultuous media presence as of late, as well as tackling his mental health, and Kid Cudi talking about his own personal journey of rebuilding himself up. There's something to love at every single turn on this album. My favorite tracks are Kid See Ghosts, Reborn, and Free Ghost Town Part 2. Nothing hurts me anymore. Guess what, baby? I feel free. And now for my runner-up, and honestly, this could have easily been my favorite album of the year. It was just such a close race. And that album is Taboo by Denzel Curry. Hot damn, he just keeps improving his music with every goddamn year, and this album is a saga. The album itself is split into 3 sections, which are supposed to represent the different sides to Curry and his thoughts on current events. Every song is extremely personal and genuine, with Curry baring himself for the entire world. As always, his writing is superb, with a great variation with wordplay and rhythm, with each song switching between down-tempo and high energy. I've absolutely loved everything he's put out so far, and I can't wait to listen what else he has in store. My favorite tracks off the album are Super Saiyan Superman, Mad I Got It, and The Blackest Balloon. Alright, now before I get to my favorite album of the year, here's my honorable mentions. Starting with remixes, Louis Vuitton and Medicine's Flip of Awake by Travis Scott, the Bloodtone remix of Honest to God by Away featuring Charity, the Neurotic remix of Unexpected Ally from the Venom soundtrack, and Sober Rob's remix of Imperfections by Diplo and Stara. Next was singles, American Guilt by Unknown Mortal Orchestra, Espionage by Laz and Lo, Lucid Dreams by Juice WRLD, We Keep on Running by What's So Not featuring Toto, Potage by Tricot, Ride by Frank Royal featuring Makana, Back to Life by Wealth and Tears, Blessed by Flicks, Pyramids of Salt by The Wonder Years, Youth by Shawn Mendes featuring Khalid, and Don't Nobody Want None by Tech9. Next with EPs, Minnesota's Curio EP and the Starlight 1 EP by Clacy Jones. And finally with albums, and you'll quickly see what I mean by just how hard it was for me to narrow down my favorite albums to just 6. Whack Roll by Tierra Whack, FM by Vince Staples, Ephemeral by Woodju, Veteran by JPEG Mafia, Krav by Quack, Beer Bongs and Bentleys by Post Malone, Prequel by Ghost, Bepiece by Corrupted Data Core, See Without Eyes by The Glitch Mob, Ascend by Pogo, Amen by Rich Brian, E for Eyes by Cupcake, Synthetic Core 88 by Equip, Chrome Sparks self-titled album, Lost 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 by Mr. Fijiwiji, Ballads 1 by Joji, Heaven and Earth by Kamasi Washington, Golden Hour by Casey Musgraves, 2012 to 2017 by Against All Logic, I Don't Run by The Hinds, Smote Reverser by The OCs, Age Of by 10 Tricks Point Never, Album 1 by Son Holo, Polychrome by Cohen Sound, Head of NASA and the Two Amish Boys by Infected Mushroom, and Trench by 21 Pilots. Alright, that was a lot, but now we can finally move on to the last album of this video, my favorite album of 2018, and it is Lab Notes Chapters 1 through 10 by Dr. Ghost. Holy shit. This album absolutely captivated me. It's structured like this story detailing the origins of the artist, Dr. Ghost, with each song being a different chapter. It was an absolute joy to listen to this album throughout the year and put together my own plot for this story based off everything I was hearing. There's such a wide range of different themes and genres present on this album. It goes from trance to breakbeat to electronica, with some Vocaloid, ambient, and breakcore thrown into the mix too. You go from this long, mysterious track in Into the Dark to this bittersweet sounding melody in Sarah's theme, through some heavy percussion in Best Laid Plans and Life After Death, before slowly coming to a close with Shutdown Notice. This album was one that I'll be looping through again and again for years to come. My favorites from it include Into Dark, Discovery of the Spirit Reactor, Sarah's Theme, Spectre Remember, and Life After Death. And that finally concludes my favorite music of 2018. Don't worry, I don't intend to upload next year's video so late into the year. Well, I mean, hopefully, at least before June. We'll see. Anyways, thank you for watching. I'll be back soon with another video.